Portsmouth, Hampshire, on the south coast of England.
When you own a boat, you love the boat, but after a while, you tend to fall out of love with the boat for whatever reason it might be. And when that happens, it gets neglected and the sea air really does take its toll on a boat. And then what happens is people completely lose interest and they abandon the things. And we're going out today to see a trider for between 5 and 10 years with nobody having gone to see it. So she's going to be fairly neglected. When the boat was new, the original owner would have paid, in today's money, between £40,000 and £50,000 for it. Obviously today she's no value. She's been left and she's been abandoned. So it's such a shame because at one point somebody really loved this boat. But now it's at the point where we are boat breakers, the undertakers of the world, are going to take her away, chop her up into fine pieces and recover the best parts so we can recycle those bits.
I think just the one in front of the red boat, just through there, with all the fenders.
Ah, there it is. She's afloat at least. We'll get on her now, we'll clip the locks off and we'll have a quick look inside.
Safely alongside, they need to stabilise the patient to begin the assessment.
I was hoping this would be nicer than this, but if you look closely, she's definitely at the end of life. There's not much that we can recover from her. We'll snip the lock off in a second, we'll have a look inside. Do you know what, we feel like modern day pirates. I don't have a blunderbuss or a knife, but I do have my portable skeleton key that lets me get into any boat. I'll hand this over to my my shipmate, Oar. The only problem we've got is that Luke's muscles aren't the greatest. Oh my word, he's done it.
That was in one.
In one. Look at that. What a guy.
Breaking an entry 101. lots of odds and sods and tools and bits and bobs, so hopefully there's a few bits we can sell or use in the yard.
There's a fog on there, Luke, see if that works. Yeah, well, we're in profit already.
A yacht that originally cost nearly £50,000 in today's money is now virtually worthless, apart from its scrap value and its beating heart.
For me, I really only want to see the engine. I see the rest of it quite quickly, but the engine could be where the money is. What have we got? Oh, there you are. An old one-cylinder Volvo. Let's see if it's seized. Bit of a treasure trove of stuff. We've found navigation, the engine doesn't look too bad.
The next challenge is towing it safely back to shore.
We tow it at length on a sort of a triangle, which gives us an even pull. It allows us to pull it very easily.
Luke volunteers to look after the abandoned yacht on her final voyage.
Now we've got control.
But towing a boat through a busy harbour is fraught with danger.
Yeah, towing boats or even driving boats, sailing boats, whatever, it's like being on a motorway sometimes, particularly here in Portsmouth Harbour. We're going dead ahead, we're about to turn to port in a moment, but just ahead of us, on the starboard bow, is a yacht coming down on us. We've got a catamaran dead ahead of us. We've got another yacht coming up on us over there. So you just need to have eyes in your backside. You've got to always be mindful that boat has got no controls. You're always fighting tide and currents and wind and elements when you're towing a boat. You're also got to be mindful that some bit of that boat might fall off whilst we're towing her. So we're always on edge, always concerned. The last thing I want to see happen to that boat is it sink right here in the middle of Portsmouth Harbour.
As they approach the boat breaking yard, Luke must test the steering and try to guide the abandoned yacht into shore.
Are you okay, Luke? The tide's nice and high, so it means we can get in really deep around the other side, which is perfect. So it's only so deep I can go. There's 10 feet under us at the moment. I can't go in much below, about 2 or 3 feet, because the bottom of my boat will hit. It gets very shallow very quickly in this area because it's not smooth like the seawater is. I'll go in backwards astern, and I'll just pull Luke in with me.
Slowly, Steve must ride the tide and try to stop himself and the stricken yacht hitting the ground.
Just be careful behind you.
The bottom of both boats, just a few inches from the seabed.
Steve,
our shallow alarm has gone off here. Yeah, we'll get out of here now before we stay aground.
Luke must drag her the last few metres.
We were warned she wasn't a great boat. Now we can see that she's definitely not a great boat. If we look at the bottom, she's absolutely full of sort of, growth on the bottom, and it'll be 2 or 3 inches thick. She's definitely beyond economical repair and really beyond even a project. So I'm more than happy to lift her out and squash her up.
On dry land, her sorry state is laid bare.
The reason why she's end of life is quite simply, there's just too many little jobs that need doing. And these little jobs, although they might only take you 2 or 3 hours, this little bit of wood might cost you 50 quid. And then, you know, to clean her up, to get all this muck and stuff offside, it'll cost you 200-300 pounds plus a couple of days of your time. Then she's got some severe wear marks around here where the gel coat has been worn by warps over the years or whatever, so that's going thin. Then we look at the more important areas. This is the rudder, believe it or not, underneath all of this. And the rudder's pretty bad. Let's scrape some of this stuff off it. It's thick, horrible muck. In fact, all this stuff is still alive. As I touch it, it all sort of shrinks back, look. Got a good 2 or 3 inches of growth here, squirting at me. Underneath all this, I'll get a quick scrape, see how deep it is. So I'm afraid it's just total scrap.
But squirting seaweed won't stop Steve and Luke from stripping Chiron of her assets. A diesel fuel tank will always sell.
And the whole point of taking the diesel tank out is to do it properly, so it doesn't leak everywhere.
So there we go, the anchor's free. I'm not sure anyone will be wanting that anchor anytime soon, but the chain's still useful.
There it comes. So, not a very big fuel tank. A lot of effort, look. A lot of effort for a little tiny fuel tank. It is as it is. She has definitely had her last sail. We like to think we never put a healthy boat down, but this one is going under.